Hello students, I am Ishan Trivedi. Welcome you in this video lecture series. Today I am going to discuss about the methods of root assignment. These methods are of all or nothing assignment method, diversion curve method, capacity restraint assignment techniques, and at last multi-root assignment techniques. So first we will understand the all or nothing assignment method. This is the simplest technique in which all the trips for a zone are classified the minimum path connecting the nodes. The minimum path is the route which has the least travel time and travel cost, or you can say distance. The technique assumes that the capacity of each link is infinite so that the volume of traffic does not affect the time of travel or the cost of travel. So what are the tasks we have? We have to find out the minimum path in the route between two zones and find out in a such a way that we have least travel time, travel cost, and the distance. So by putting these parameters, we have the two stages. Here first is the network description and the tree building that we are going to made here. Then the next stage is to assign the traffic flows to the minimum path tree. If I'm talking about the limitation, then we need to understand why there is some limitation over here. If the time alone is used as a governing factor in selecting the minimum path, the other important characteristics or factors like cost, distance, safety will be neglected, and we have to focus on the only time factor. In a network with two or more parallel and the close links, the link which is the only marginally quicker will be allocated all the trips, and resulting flow pattern may lead to the unrealistic situation. Too many vehicles tend to be assigned to more attractive routes, and that's why this may cause increasing in the congestion on these routes, and this technique takes no account of this factor. Here all those facilities in the network are not effectively utilized. If a superior facility is available, for example, you can say a motorway, the people tend to prefer to use this facility for the longer journeys only. And this technique does not reflect this tendency of people to adopt such facilities. So these are the limitations of the all or nothing assignment method. Now understand the second method, that is the diversion curve method. Diversion curve method is one of the frequently used assignment technique of this route assignment. This method predicts the percentage of trips that are likely to use a proposed new facilities. These are of bypass, new expressways, new arterial streets in the city area, which are based on the distance saved, or you can say time saved, or the cost saved. These are our parameters, and the data collected from these pattern of road usage in the past serve to build up such curves. You can see the curves here. Here these diversion curves can be constructed using various variables such as travel time saved, distance that has saved during those things, then travel time ratio, distance ratio, travel time and distance saved, and travel cost ratio, distance and speed ratio. So we are going to understand by one example. So here the diversion curve, you can see here, that is done using one variable, and that is the time ratio to determine the traffic diverted to the expressway, that is the Bureau of Public Road Curve. Here this formula has been used for the this kind of curve, you can say, and that is P is equal to 100 upon 1 plus TR raised to 6, where P stands for percentage of traffic that diverted on the new system. TR is nothing but the travel time ratio, which is equal to travel time on the new system upon the travel time on the old system. Here, the California diversion of highway based on their observation on freeway in California in 1956, they have developed an equation for arriving and percentage use of freeway, and that is P is equal to 50 plus 50 into D plus 0.5 T upon D minus 0.5 T raised to 2 plus 4.5 whole raised to 0.5, where P stands for the percentage of motorway usage, D stands for distance saved in the miles on new route, then T stands for time saved in minutes on the new route. Here the main drawback of this diversion curve assignment is that there are only two alternative routes for each pair of zone are considered. And the technique is that's why suitable for the new bypass and the new motorways only. So this is the theory of diversion curve technique. Now we are going to understand the capacity restraint assignment technique, which is also known as a CRAT. The capacity restraint assignment technique involves a sequence of all or nothing minimum path assignment, where the sequence is iterated until the traffic volume assigned to each link are comparable with the link that travel time assumed in the minimum path tree building phase. The link travel time used in the assignment is a function of speed on that particular link, which again is independent on the traffic flow being assigned. Because of the iterative nature of this calculation involved, this technique is carried out entirely by the computers only. Here we have some models based on the capacitive restraint techniques. These are of a Detroit model and TRC technique. First, we will understand here the Detroit model. In the Detroit area traffic study, an iterative procedure was utilized. In this study, the traffic was assigned to various links using all or nothing approach. Here, the speed assumed for the initial assignment was the free speed, and for each link, travel time was modified based on an equation, and that is TA is equal to TOE into V upon C minus 1, where TA is equal to adjusted time travel time, TO is the original assigned travel, V stands for assigned volume, C stands for computed capacity. Here, the second iteration was accomplished by using new travel time that we have computed and to determine a new series of maximum path or trees. So this is the Detroit method of capacity restraint assignment techniques. Now our second model is the TRC trip assignment model, which is part of the CRAT model. This model involves two travel time versus volume relationship using iteratively, or you can say to arrive at the prediction of volume on separate routes between any two zones. The equation used for predicting the volume on the route R is given by a formula, and that is VR is equal to 1 upon TR upon summation of 1 upon TR, where R is equal to 1 to M into V value. Here, the VR stands for the volume of traffic on route R, and that is vehicle per R per lane. V stands for the total volume of traffic or you can say trips from zone I to zone J on all the route M. And TR is nothing but the travel time on route R in minutes. As seen from this formula, the decrease in the TR value leads to an increase of 1 upon TR value. As you can see, if the TR value decreases, there is increase in the 1 upon TR value. And corresponding increase in the proportion of V value, or you can say V trips, which are assigned to the route R value. The value of T for the iterations is found out by the formula, and that is small TR is equal to TRC plus D into VR minus VRC upon VRC into LR, where TRC is nothing but the volume of traffic on route R, that is vehicle per R per lane. TR is the travel time on route R in minutes. V stands for the volume of traffic on route R, which is vehicle per R per lane. LR is the length of route R in kilometer. D is the delay parameter in minute per mile. Here the value of D is given by two criteria. That is, D is equal to 0.5 for the VR less than VRC, and D is equal to 10 where the VR is greater than VRC. So this is the CR80 model for this route assignment. Now understand the next model, that is the multi-route assignment technique. All road users may not be able to judge the minimum path for themselves. It may also happen that the all road user may not have the same criteria for judging the shortest route. And these limitations of all or nothing approach are recognized in a multiple route assignment technique. The method consists of assigning the interzonal flow to a series of routes, and the proportion of the total flow assigned to each being a function of length of the route in the relation to the shortest route. McLaughlin developed one multiple traffic assignment technique where a driver's route selection criteria is used, which is a function of travel time, travel cost, and accident potential. Here, minimum resistance path between origin and destination pair are calculated with all the link resistance set to the values which correspond to a zero traffic volume. So, this is the theory of multi-route assignment technique. Here, I am ending this session. I hope you have learned the methods of route assignment. Thanks for watching this video.